Hi, today we are going to read the book Trouble in Tall Town. It's a story by Peter MacDonald. Tommy Tickles and his family packed up their house in Short City. Short City was too short. They moved to Tall Town. It seemed just right. But summer was over. It was almost time for school to start. As a new student, Tommy had to go to school a day early to meet his teacher. "Yippee," Tommy said. "Hurry up," Tommy's mother said, "or you'll be later than late." Tommy's father came to the door. "Think big," he said. "See you later, alligator," he said to his parents. Tommy waved goodbye as he headed for the door. "After a while, crocodile," his parents said together. Tommy rolled down the ramp. Zoom! He whisked down the sidewalk. Zip! Tommy's new school was only a block away. When Tommy got there, he could not find the door. He rolled around the entire building. "Where is it?" he said. He scratched his head. He rolled around again. "How do I get inside?" he wondered. Then he looked up. He saw the door. It was two stories off the ground. "Oh my goodness," he said. There were no steps to reach it. There was no ramp he could roll up to get inside. "This sure is strange," Tommy said. He looked around for someone to ask. No one was around. "They are probably inside already," Tommy thought, "because I'm late." But wait, there was a sound coming from behind the apple tree. Someone stepped out from behind the tree. "Hello, I'm Lenny Laughter. I'm the shortest boy in Tall Town," he said. Just then, another boy walked up. "And I'm Frank Funny. I'm the tallest boy in Tall Town." His voice was as deep as a well. "We can't get inside," Lenny said. "Well, I'm Tommy Tickles," Tommy said, "and this sure is strange. I have always been able to get into school." "Me too," Lenny said. "This new school was built over the summer. I guess they forgot to add steps." "And a ramp," Tommy said. "What are we going to do?" No one seemed to have an answer. But all of a sudden, the schoolhouse door opened. "Yoo-hoo!" the voice called out. "I'm Mr. Pancake. I'm your new teacher. I've been stuck in the school for 4 days. Last week, I went in for a peek," he said. "The school was much shorter when I went in. I got tired inside. I took a nap. While I was asleep, the Tall Town builders came back. They made the school taller from the bottom up. So now the door is all the way up here." "But they forgot to add stairs and a ramp," Tommy said. "Exactly," Mr. Pancake said. "So now I'm stuck up here." "And we are stuck down here," said Lenny. "But I have a solution," Mr. Pancake said. "I need your help. I need your muscles." "Can you build a ramp and steps to reach me?" Mr. Pancake asked. "How?" asked Frank. "I'll teach you how," Mr. Pancake said with glee. "This will be our first lesson in school. First, you need to gather wood. Then you need to find a saw. Then you need a hammer and nails. Be very careful with the saw, the hammer and the nails. And don't get splinters from the wood," Mr. Pancake said. "Go get those things and I'll teach you how to build a ramp. We will have to work together." "We can do this," Tommy said. "We can get this done in the blink of a wink." Tommy got wood from the Tall Town wood pile. Frank got a saw from the Tall Town tool shop. Lenny located a hammer and nails. Together they cut the wood, they made the ramp. They made it higher and higher and higher still. Phew, they said, building a ramp was hard work. How about some apples? Mr. Pancake said. He picked an apple for everyone. Students are supposed to give apples to teachers, Lenny said, not the other way around. Today is different, Mr. Pancake said. He tossed the apples down. The boys sat down, they took a break. Chomp, chomp, they ate the delicious apples. Yummy in my tummy, Frank said. Then the break was over. They sat back to work. They wanted to finish what they had started. Mr. Pancake cheered them on. The boys made a ramp faster than the tall town builders. Frank sawed the wood, Tommy tore it up, Lenny nailed it down. Almost there, Mr. Pancake shouted. Tommy's arms were tired of towing. Lenny's legs were at the limit. Frank's fingers felt feeble. Only 2 more feet of ramp, Mr. Pancake shouted. We can do it, Frank said. We will do it, Tommy said. Frank sawed the last piece of wood. Tommy towed it up. Lenny laid it in place. You did it, Mr. Pancake said. We did it, everyone cheered. With teamwork, Mr. Pancake said, you all get A+ for the day. We could not have done it without you, Tommy said. You get an A+ too. For the rest of the afternoon, everyone sat down. They laughed and talked. They ate apples until they couldn't eat any more. The end.